Ontario Science Centre, and today I have a very special guest with me.
Sammy, and I'm her father.
That's right, and today we're going to be doing an experiment making mini vortex cannons, and we're going to be writing down our experiment in our...
Dying Notebook!
That's right, let's get started.
For this experiment, you will need a plastic water bottle or another type of sturdy cylinder, a balloon, and some type of tape. I like to use duct tape for this experiment. To make the air cannon, all you have to do is puncture the water bottle so that you can remove the top part from the rest of the water bottle. You'll need the top part, but you can set the rest aside. Next, take the balloon. You'll have to cut off the neck of the balloon so that the skinny part is gone and you just have the big round part left. Then, stretch that round part over the biggest opening of the water bottle and tape it in place. There you have it! You've made your own mini vortex air cannon. Here's our experiment. We're going to be testing each cannon 3 times. We're going to shoot it 3 times at a target and check if it hits the bullseye. That will tell us how accurate the cannon is. We're also going to be testing it by holding the bullseye farther and farther back. We're going to be trying to hit the bullseye, but we're also testing to see how far they can just hit the target in general. So we're going to be testing how accurate they are, how good they are at hitting the bullseye, and how strong they are, or how far away we can hold the target and they'll still be able to hit it. Let's give it a whirl. Great experimenting. It was hard work, right, Sam?
Yeah.
Yeah. We did our experiment 7 times. Each time, we tested each air cannon from another foot back. So we tested it at 1 foot away, 2 feet away, 3 feet away, all the way up to 7 feet back. And we learned some things from our experiment, didn't we, Sam?
Yeah.
It looks like one of these air cannons didn't work very well. Which one was that?
Third one.
That's right. This third one, it didn't hit the target at all. I thought it would be a good test to see if a larger opening made a difference, but it seems like it didn't make a good difference.
No.
Which one do you think was the best?
Best and this one.
Ooh! Number one. That's right. Based on our experiment, number one hit the target every time. It didn't always hit the bullseye, but it was very strong. It was able to hit the target every time. Let's talk about accuracy. We got a lot of yeses on our sheet. We were able to hit the target when we were standing nice and close.
Sometimes say no. For sure, or yes.
Yeah.
But some is no.
That's right. Even at 1 foot away, this one did get a no. There was one time when we shot it and we didn't hit the bullseye, even though we were so close. But sometimes that happens.
Yes.
That's why we ran the experiment so many times. We did it 3 tries for each one so that we could get good results. And that's what we learned. So if you guys want to try to make one at home, you can learn from our experience and know having a giant opening like this didn't work very well.
Sometimes, yes.
Yeah. No, that one was our no, not ever.
Sometimes.
Yeah, it might. If we keep trying it again.
Yeah.
And this one, it worked sometimes.
Yeah.
It was pretty good. And this one, with a wider opening, worked best. I think they should try it at home and tell us so we know what your results are, and together we can build the absolute best vortex cannon. Give it a whirl.